Welcome back to my channel. This is Ranjiraj and you are streaming on the Study Beast. So today's topic will be based on the biological neural networks. So first of all, when you see this board, you may find that this would be a biology lecture, but this is not a biology tutorial. It's all about the neurons and how it is processed that you need to understand first in order to create or in order to impute compute into the soft computing agent. So first of all, you need to understand what is these neural networks. It took me a considerable amount of time to understand what this particular thing and how it works and how all the impulses are being sent. So this you need to first understand before jumping on to the next level. That is, successor of this is called as the perceptrons, which we use in soft computing. In human brains we have these neurons, likewise in computers we have the perceptrons, which works in a similar manner like how this neurons will be working. So let's get started. So ready? So first of all, when you talk about the neurons, in my earlier video, in my introduction to soft computing, I've discussed all the main points, or like it was a summary what the soft computing would be, what all components it would have, what all constituents it is comprised of. Now basically we are talking about the neurons. So neurons is a vital essential component, or in the brain it will be used for controlling all of the activities. Voluntary and involuntary activities are all controlled by these neurons. So likewise we have the term biological neural network. So it will be a basically a network inside the brain, which is very complex, and millions of neurons are there. So from that I am picking up one particular neuron and I am zooming it and I am studying the detail of it, what all components it has. So if any medical students are watching this video, just bear me, like I don't have much knowledge about this, so it took me a much amount of time to understand this. So let's get started. So first of all, when you pick up or like a branch, when you pick up a branch from that particular neuron, you may find this diagram. So as you can see, this diagram moreover consists like a branch of a stem from a tree. So it consists of a nucleus which is in round shape. I don't know what is actually composed in that nucleus, and it has some like what you can say like leaves or some roots you can say present, which are called as the dendrites, that I have labeled here, that is the dendrites. And it has a one long elongated branch called as the axon, and then it has this portion which you can see called as the soma, and then it has like some synapses which acts as a node in terms of like in biology these are termed as synapses, while in computer programming it is called as like some other internal networks, or like for addition or subtraction some functions we may use here, operators. So in biology these are termed as synapses, which is used basically for joining of this all interconnectivity, like for sending impulses and signals. This comes into picture. Now let us see what all functionalities or how this is actually processed. So first of all, what dendrites are. So dendrites will basically accept any input from the external agent. So dendrite will take, or it will accept happily any input, whether it is an emotion or whether it is a consciousness or whether it is sadness, agony, angry or something like that. Then we have the axons, this branch which you can see, and this axon will take the input from its dendrites. It would be receiving like from here, it would be receiving all the signals which you get or the impulses from various parts of the body, and then it processes and converts it into the output. So whatever input we get from the dendrites are processed internally within these axons, and they are given to the output. Then the soma processes all the input. So first of all, when it comes here, it goes into this, completely processes it, and then it will send to the axon for outputting. And then synapses are the electrochemical contact between the neurons. So it just acts as a interconnectivity, like or link between two or more axons or like dendrites. So anywhere it is present. So these synapses are just electrochemical contact. Nothing much about that. And then we have this model, like this can be thought of like you are getting several inputs, like when you are in the day working or when you are sleeping in the night, when you get dreams and all. So just like the inputs coming in and out. So this is the input layer, an overview of this. And then is the hidden layer, which like many processes goes on inside this. And then finally some output is given out, like the output layer. Like some one impulse or some signals which you may get, like a jerk or something like that. So first of all, you understand this biological networks. Then for example, if we have like, if I write example TTL, now as a human being I can understand that talk to you later, like TTYL it should be, talk to you later, but this computer agent does not understand what is TTYL unless and until you feed it like what T stands for, what second T stands for, what Y stands for, L stands for. Otherwise it would not like recognize what this is. GR8, we laymen can understand that it is great, but computers cannot. If it is XLR8, then it will give some error what this XLR8, but we understand it's accelerate. We like we convert, or we have that practice to convert it. So these are like small areas where we need to improve this computer agent's ability in reading this and converting it to particular output. Similarly, you may find like translation of some sentences, like in English sentences into Arabic or German or something like that, that the machine can easily understand. Like it may have an inbuilt translator to translate it. But when that particular German is written in English, or when other languages, like when if it is a Hindi or Marathi or some other regional languages, when that particular language is implemented in English, then it cannot identify. Even we had a like a pretty much difficulty in understanding those, but when it comes to machines, then it needs a much higher level of abstraction and clearance for decoding this. So this is all about the biological neural networks. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. Thanks for watching this video.